Hello everyone, this is Shweta Kale. Today I'm going to give you some information about cable modem and DSL technologies. So these are some topics about cable modem and DSL technologies which we are going to study in this presentation. Our first topic is cable modem, overview of cable modem, working, features and its advantages. And the second topic is DSL technologies, overview, working, types and its advantages. So, our first topic is cable modem. As we all know, internet is a network of network. A cable modem is a hardware device that allows your computer to communicate with an internet service provider over a landline connection. It converts an analog signal to a digital signal for the purpose of granting access to broadband internet. Cable modems are primarily used to deliver broadband internet access in the form of cable internet, taking advantages of high bandwidth offer, hybrid fiber coax and radio frequency over glass network, that is HFC and RFUG network. To access internet through a cable TV, computer network require a cable modem. It has two interfaces on it, one for the computer and other for the cable network. The computer side interface is usually is a USB interface or 10 Mbps Ethernet. The cable network is a common cable wire interface. This modem makes a connection when it is turned on. Cable modems are always retaining the connection because the cable operator does not charge for the duration of connection unless they are switched off. This is the diagram shows the working of cable modem. The coaxial cable connects to your cable modem, which is in turn connects to an Ethernet card in your PC. The function of the cable modem is to connect broadband, that is the cable television network, to Ethernet once the Ethernet card has been installed and the TCP/IP software is installed on your PC. As we can see here, a cable modem consists of RF tuner, QAM demodulator, QPSK QAM modulator, MAC and data and logical unit. It can be either internal or external to the computer. In some cases, the cable modem can be a part of set-top box requiring that only a keyboard and mouse can be deleted for internet, can be added for internet access. This can be done using one-to-one splitter. So, about the features of cable modem. A cable modem does modulation between analog and digital signals. It is a much more complex device than a telephone modem. The cable modem attaches to a standard 10-bus Ethernet card in the computer. The network layer is chosen as internet protocol to support the internet and worldwide services. Current cable modem use Ethernet card frame format for data transmission over upstream and downstream channels. Advantages of cable modem. From the beginning of the broadband wars, cable modems have outshined their DSL counterparts in terms of downloaded speeds. There is no signal degradation over a distance, meaning that a subscriber in one neighborhood receives the same quality of a signal as subscriber living in neighborhood 10 miles further away from the substation. Means it is equal for the nearer and further away. Cable offers more consistent connection quality with fewer lost packets on average according to both the industry and independent studies. So, our next topic is DSL, that is digital subscriber line. DSL provides high-speed internet access over local loops. The digital subscriber line broadband is a bit different because it relies on residential telephone lines to provide a web access. Transfer protocol cables used for local loops has a bandwidth of 1.1 MHz. They provide bandwidth of 4 kHz using filters to allow multiplexing of large number of voice channels. About the working of DSL, when you connect to the internet, you might connect through a regular modem, through a local area network connection in your office, cable modem, or through a digital subscriber line connection. DSL is a very high speed connection that uses the same wire as a regular telephone line. Most homes and small businesses users are connected to an asymmetric DSL, that is ADSL line. Asymmetric DSL divides up the available frequencies in a line on the assumption that most internet users look at or download much more information than they send or upload. Under this assumption, if the connection speed from the internet to the user is 3 to 4 times faster than the connection faster to the user back to the internet, then the user will see the benefit of most of the time. This diagram shows the relation between subscriber and exchange. The phone network and the internet gives their signal to the port switch and DSL AC respectively. It can both connect to the DSLAM and then by the subscriber line, it can go to the filter for the subscriber. It gives to the NTBA and DSL modem and work through the phone and PC. About the asymmetric DSL, on a data rate just similar to the modem with fallback rates, deliberate asymmetry in upstream and downstream connection. Higher bandwidth downstream is given to the subscriber and lower bandwidth downstream is given to the internet. ADSL tests the condition and bandwidth availability. Just you can see here, the PSTN uses 0 to 4 kHz bandwidth. For the upstream, we can use 25.875 kHz to 138 kHz bandwidth. And for downstream, that is, which is given to the subscriber, we can give 138 kHz to 1104 kHz downstream bandwidth. DMT. DMT actually is a modulation technique used by the DSL. DMT means discrete multitone technique. It has a usable frequency range, is separated into 256 frequency band of 4.3125 kHz. It is a method separating the digital subscriber line signal so that usable frequency range is separated into 256 frequency bands of 4.3125 kHz each. DMT uses the fast Fourier transform algorithm for modulation and demodulation. Dividing the frequency spectrum into multiple channels allows DMT to work better than AM radio transmitter are present. Within each channel, modulation use quadrature amplitude modulation, that is QAM, and frequency division multiplexing, that is FDM. By varying the number of bits per symbol within a channel, the modem can be rate adaptive. So now about the XDSL. XDSL has a different types like SDSL. SDSL is a symmetrical DSL. It is unlike ADSL. The bandwidth partitioning of a SDSL is symmetrical. It is more suitable for businesses. About the HDSL, that is high bit rate DSL. It is an alternative to T1 1.544 Mbps line, which uses AMI encoding. AMI is susceptible to attenuation at higher frequencies. Thus, it repeaters needed every 1 km. HDSL uses 2B1Q encoding, reaches data rates up to 2 Mbps without repeaters over 3.6 km distance. Two TP wires for full duplex connections that will be needed by HDSL. Very high bit rate DSL, that is VDSL, similar to the ADSL but uses coaxial fiber optic or TP for higher rates over short distance, that is 300 to 1800 meter only. It has a bandwidth of 50 to 55 Mbps downstream and 1.5 to 2.5 Mbps downstream. About the advantages of DSL, you can leave your internet connection open and still use the phone line for voice calls. The speed is much higher than the regular modem. DSL doesn't necessarily require new wiring. It can use the phone line you already have. The company that offers DSL will usually provide the modem as part of the installation. So, these are the references by which we are able to make this presentation. First is computer.howstuffwork.com for the DSL, wikipedia.org for the DSL, and computerhope.com jargon cablemod.htm. And we uses the book named as Orozone. Sorry, it is CCN by a Orozone. Thank you so much, guys. Thank you so much for listening to our best presentation. This presentation is licensed to the public. Text is available under the Creative Commons Attribution Share Alike license. Thank you.